Hey guys, what's up? Shadowlands back with another review. Today I'm getting around to the next Black Dragon weapon, the Black Dragon Desert Eagle. Now, overall, this gun looks, you know, completely badass. It is a Black Dragon weapon. That's what it's supposed to look like. It looks a little like a, you know, Desert Eagle gold. It's got that goldish color, but instead of a tiger, it has a dragon, you know, given the name. You know, some people might guess that. Just saying. Anyway, so before we go on, let's do the stats. Stats are important. Damage is 70, portability is 85, rate of fire is 11, accuracy is 61, and the recoil is 66. It is a fully automatic pistol. Most people don't seem to know that for some reason. It actually was the very first fully automatic pistol in the game, the Desert Eagle series, I mean. And overall, it just performs not that well for most situations. It is a flanking weapon, as you can see here. Flanking works very well with it because, you know, you get the back shot usually, and people don't see it coming. You can usually pull off two shots. If you miss at that range, probably shouldn't be playing this game. But overall, it's a really fun weapon to use. I mean, I think it's fun. It's not the most practical to use. I would never use it in a clan war, but for the most part, I love using it in just pubs because it's fun to use, I guess. I can't really explain that. But overall, the damage drop-off of these weapons is horrendous. It is absolutely awful. It can be up to a 4-shot kill at maximum range despite having 70 damage. That is really, really bad. And that's even on a recon or a light vester, so don't really know what's going on there, Nexon. Fix your crap. But if there was any weapon in the game that I wish you could put a scope on, this would be it, because if you could make this weapon more accurate, that would be awesome. Now, the damage up close is pretty accurate. It's going to do about 70 damage, and it can be a one-shot kill occasionally if they've taken some damage. Depends on what weapon they've been shot with. It's usually something you want to use as a finisher weapon, so if you do a ton of damage with your primary, run out of ammo or something, whip out your Desert Eagle, land one shot, and that should be enough to kill them most of the time. As long as they have, you know, around 60 HP, that should probably be fine. Usually get the kill if you're close enough, so that's always good. The portability is very high in this. It's 85. You're going to run pretty fast with all Desert Eagle family variants, pretty much. The rate of fire of 11 is very, very low. It's like less than some snipers, so please be very careful when doing that. That's like the number one reason people fail with the Desert Eagle, is because it doesn't fire fast enough. The recoil is huge. The spread's going to jump up a lot with every single shot, so you need to be very, very accurate, very, very careful. This is the gun you need to crouch with. The spread is gigantic, to the point where it's almost unusable. The M9-2FS variant series just typically has an easier to control spread than this gun does. Landing a shot with the Desert Eagle series is, you know, let's put it this way. I feel like the gun series was designed for the sole and primary purpose of missing every single shot. Even if you crouch, this weapon seems to miss every single shot, no matter what variant you use. I usually use the American Eagle or the Black Deagle. Just, those are the ones I prefer. Now, there is a tactic I have with using all of these variants, and I suggest you guys use it as well. You'll notice the ammo capacity is exactly 7 of 7. An extended magazine 2 for a pistol gives you an extra 7 shots. So if you put on a extended magazine 2 on any Deagle variant except for the Black Deagle and the Gold Deagle, you will still be able to make it so you can't reload. Now, well, not that you can't reload, but that you won't have to. You'll have all 14 shots in one magazine, and you don't have to worry about reloading, which is nice. Now, that being said, the reload actually isn't half bad on this. The draw speed and the reload are both pretty fast on these weapons, so that's usually not an issue. I guess it's to help counterbalance, but overall, that's about all I have to say for these weapons. Thank you guys for watching. Please rate, comment, subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next video. Don't forget to subscribe. Shadowlands out. Round start. Enemy down.